Jewelry store is a smaller shop with one or two people, a somewhat limited variety of jewelry. Well, Kelmer's was anything but. I was impressed with the magnitude and elegance of the showroom. And as I wandered from showcase to showcase, there was a selection of diamonds and gold jewelry easily worth millions of dollars. But what impressed me most were the values for these exceptional objects of jewelry. Indeed, I found Jack Kelmer's jewelers to be as exceptional as the jewelry they offer. If you want the advice of a good friend, go there.
Jack Kelmer, 717 Chestnut Street, Philadelphia, the Ellisburg Circle, Cherry Hill, and coming soon to 569 West Lancaster Avenue in Haverford. Good morning. WFLN time is 8:05. I'm Dave Conant, and on a bright autumn day, here's some bright trumpet sounds. The music of John Stanley. Performance polished up for compact disc by Roger Voisin and the Cap Sinfonietta, a trumpet tune by John Stanley. WFLN time is 8:10. He created a mood of rapture and exultation. At the end, the entire audience justifiably exploded into a standing ovation. That's what Donald Henahan of the New York Times wrote of the playing of pianist Edward Aldwell, who will be presented by the Bach Festival of Philadelphia on Saturday, November 3rd at 8 p.m. at the Woodmere Art Museum. When Mr. Aldwell played his distinguished cycles of Bach performances in New York, audiences and critics were immediately struck by this extraordinary musical figure, a mind attuned to Bach's prodigious structures and an artist with a special gift for conveying the dramatic expression of Bach's music. On November 3rd, Edward Aldwell will perform the complete Goldberg variations as well as the overture in the French manner. A limited number of tickets are still available for this recital and may be purchased by calling the Bach Festival at 247-BACH. That's 247-BACH. Well, H-E-L-L-O, it's sunny, about 41 degrees now, with a high going to the, the outside, mid-50s. Right now, 41. At 11 past 8 o'clock, we'll do a little marching, courtesy of Sir Edward Elgar. This is a coronation march for George V, dating back to 1911. The London Symphony, conducted here by Barry Tuckwell. certainly hope George V appreciated that one. The Coronation March by Sir Edward Elgar with Barry Tuckwell and the London Symphony Orchestra. 8:21 the time. And the forecast is finally reflecting reality. Mostly sunny, a high in the low to mid-50s. At the airport now it is nowhere. It's 44.
This is Judy Salzberg of Salzberg and Levin, independent insurance agents at Independence Mall. Nursing home and home nursing protection is so important because with advanced medical technology, we're living longer. Medical plans limit hospital and home care benefits, so more and more financial burden falls on you and your loved ones. Quality long-term care runs as high as $50,000 a year, about $1,000 a week. Can you afford that? Don't leave a spouse impoverished or become a burden to your children. You've insured your home, your health, your car. Now insure everything you've worked so hard to accumulate. With so many top companies offering various affordable plans, you need an expert to guide you. We are the experts. As independent agents, we work for you. To learn what is best for you at no obligation, call me, Judy Salzberg, at 925-1188. That's 925-1188, 925-1188.
There's nothing that touches the heart quite like a piano. And no one knows this better than Michael Sweeney, piano craftsman, the number one source for those who wish to buy, sell, or restore a piano. Give him a call in his Ardmore shop at 896-1886. Michael Sweeney, piano craftsman.
Arthur Fiedler, the Boston Pops, and the Valdres March by Johannes Hansen, sometimes known as the John Philip Sousa of Norway, making John Philip Sousa the Johannes Hansen of the U.S., I guess. WFLN time, 8:27.
Ralph Collier for Bernard Haldane Associates. Today, more than ever before, change is happening fast in the job market. How quickly can you adapt? And who can interpret changes for you? Highly significant questions, and Bernard Haldane Associates can answer them for you now. For over 40 years, Bernard Haldane has been helping men and women find the right job, showing them how to move up, move ahead in the business world. It was Haldane who wrote the bestseller, How to Make a Habit of Success. And Haldane can help you. Simply call them at 854-0313. Neither fee nor obligation for the initial session. And if you like, tell them Ralph Collier suggested you call. That's 854-0313. The name, Bernard Haldane. And Haldane will help. They've helped thousands.
So will Mark Davies, if you pay attention, Mark.
Well, we'll do our best. Eastbound Schuylkill Expressway is running generally slow from the Blue Route through Belmont. And again, it's backed up from the Roosevelt Boulevard through Girard. Westbound is slow west of Pass Young through south and the Boulevard through Belmont. Backed up at the Conshohocken Curve through the Conshohocken exit itself. And now down to a minor delay as you approach 202. Pennsylvania Turnpike westbound still slow for a half a mile approaching the Valley Forge off-ramp. Continues slow there as you make your way toward the tolls. Southbound 95 generally slow from Academy through Girard. In Delaware County, 10-minute delays in both directions. North and southbound on 95 through those construction zones. Coming in from New Jersey, northbound 42 is generally jammed from 544 and the inner drive up to approaching the Walt Whitman Bridge because of a disabled vehicle there in the inner drive. The outer drive, though, traffic is getting by without too much of a problem. If you can make the switch to the outer drive, please do. West of the Walt Whitman, slow traffic there from the downside through the tolls. And that's shuttle traffic for WFLN, brought to you by Sloan, Toyota, and Pontiac on the corner of Jenkintown and Easton Roads in Glenside. I'm Mark Davies.
If you travel on business, you know that nothing beats traveling for pleasure. After all, only then can you pick where you want to go, when you want to go, and with whom you want to go. But if there's anything that beats traveling for pleasure, it's traveling for pleasure free. You know, with a lot of airlines, you have to fly and fly and fly until you've accumulated enough frequent flyer miles to earn a free trip, but not with TWA. You see, with TWA's frequent flight bonus program, after only 20,000 miles, you earn a free round-trip ticket to anywhere TWA flies in the continental United States. After only 35,000 miles, you earn a free round-trip ticket to Europe. And perhaps best of all, unlike those other airlines, your TWA frequent flyer miles never expire. And you don't even have to use your TWA frequent flyer miles to get free upgrades to business or first class. TWA, the airline with the kind of frequent flight bonus program you want with the benefits you deserve. TWA understands the needs of today's business flyer.
This is Classical Music Radio, WFLN in Philadelphia, 8:30, Monday morning, the 29th of October, 1990. With sunny skies, it's 44 degrees. The news is brought to you by Wayne Jewelers and Silversmiths, Lancaster Avenue, Wayne, King of Prussia Plaza, and Suburban Square, Ardmore. The UN Security Council is ready to strike another blow at Iraq. The council today is expected to vote on a resolution demanding reparations from Iraq for the damage done to occupied Kuwait. A six-nation grouping of Persian Gulf Arab states says the region is on the brink of war, but that diplomacy is still an option. The Gulf Cooperation Council met in Saudi Arabia today, and its chairman said later, a lot of things remain in the hands of Iraqi President Saddam Hussein. The government is operating on yet another temporary spending bill that's good through November 5th. Congress passed a deficit reduction plan on Saturday, but President Bush won't sign it until sometime after he gets back to Washington from his current campaign trip. And the president's taking a nosedive in the polls, but he's trying to boost support for Republican candidates just the same. In San Francisco today, Bush will stump for Senator Pete Wilson, who's in a neck-and-neck race for governor of California. Our morning financial report, sports and weather after this.
Wayne Jewelers and Silversmiths is not the first jewelry store to discuss service. They all talk about it. The question is, how many jewelry stores are truly able to stand behind the promises they make? Wayne Jewelers can and does. They realize that good service is more than a cordial smile and a friendly salesperson. Rather, educating their customers to where they feel confident in making a purchase is what service is all about. And to serve someone as completely as possible, it means you have to know what you're talking about. A lot of false information about jewelry is given out because salespeople are usually trained just to sell, not to know what they're selling. Wayne Jewelers feels their biggest competitor is misrepresentation, and they realize it's crucial that they stay informed so they can be of their greatest service to you. Discover real service at Wayne Jewelers and Silversmiths, Lancaster Avenue in Wayne, Suburban Square Ardmore, and the King of Prussia Plaza. Member, American Gem Society.
And now our morning financial report brought to you by Jenny Montgomery Scott, the Delaware Valley's leading investment firm since 1832. And live from their Center City offices, here's Gene Peroni. Morning, Gene.
Good morning, Dave. The gravity of uncertainties facing investors in recent weeks, ranging in topics from the federal budget deficit and the banking system to the Mideast crisis and the price of oil, have left deep psychological scars in the stock market. This is evident in the Dow's irregular and inconsistent rally attempts. The formidable constraints imposed by descending trendline resistance, which on a near-term basis now stands around 2510, indicates that extensive base building may be required before a meaningful recovery can begin. In the meantime, the Dow is apt to produce expansive swings that fall within a trading range orientation. The Dow finished on Friday at 2436. We feel the market will test a little bit above its recent lows around the 2380 area, and then we'll find problems around 2510. So that should pretty much reflect the near-term trading range. Even if President Bush signs the budget proposal into law, as expected shortly, the plan is laden with tax increases that could further burden our recessionary economy. Therefore, traders will be watching and waiting for signs of the Fed's willingness to ease credit. Interest rates will be an important factor in determining fair value in stocks over the short run. This is Gene Peroni at Jenny Montgomery Scott.
Thank you, Gene. Randall Cunningham's 10-yard touchdown pass to Calvin Williams with 44 seconds left rescued a 21-20 victory yesterday for the Eagles over the Cowboys. And Flyers goaltender Ron Hextall will be examined today so that the team doctors can assess the leg injury he suffered in Saturday's 5-2 loss to the Islanders. The temperature is 44, the humidity 53, winds out of the west at a brisk 14 miles per hour, the barometer rising 30.19, and the WFLN forecast mostly sunny, a high in the low to mid-50s today. Clear and cold tonight, 30 to 35, and for tomorrow, sunny and milder with a high in the low to mid-60s, right now 44. The hour's top story, the UN Security Council is ready to strike another blow at Iraq. The council is expected to vote on a resolution demanding reparations from Iraq for the damage done to occupied Kuwait. And that's the news on the Morning Financial Report brought to you by Wayne Jewelers and Silversmith, Lancaster Avenue, Wayne, King of Prussia Plaza, and Suburban Square, Ardmore. Next news on WFLN at 9.
For years, you've worked at making your business a financial success, and now you've decided to sell. That's why it's more important than ever to invest wisely.
I didn't come this far to get hurt now. A safe, steady return will do.
In these uncertain times, the Glenn Mead Trust Company can be called upon to manage your newly acquired assets with highly personalized attention that is most sensitive to your needs and disciplined investment strategies that are based on one sound philosophy, the preservation of capital.
In the future, I want to be able to enjoy the same financial security I have now.
If your assets are substantial and you seek the security we strive for, the Glenn Mead Trust Company would be pleased to serve you. Call J. Thomas Dunleavy at the Glenn Mead Trust Company, 875-5843. 875-5843. The Glenn Mead Trust Company, Rittenhouse Square, Philadelphia. Most personal, most secure.
And good morning. You're most welcome to join us as we continue with music, this by Antonio Vivaldi. His Flute Concerto in F, Opus 10, number 1. Keeping track of all of these, I hope. Jean-Pierre Rampal with I Celesti Veneti, conducted by Claudio Scimone.
Thank you. Thank you.
Claudio Schimone, Isliste di Veneti, and Jean-Pierre Rampal, flute with the Concerto in F by Antonio Vivaldi. WFLN time, 16 and a half before 9 o'clock. And it's time for Skywatch Part 2 with Dick James, brought to you by Custom Air. For carrier heating, sales, service, and installation, call 638-0218. Winter, it's just around the corner. You'll know that tonight. In the cold months ahead, you'll want to be sure your heating system is operating at top capacity, and that's why you'll want to contact Custom Air, specializing in carrier heating and cooling systems for more than two decades. And right now, Custom Air is offering you terrific savings on carrier gas furnaces. Receive a $150 rebate on carrier's remarkable new Weathermaker Infinity gas furnace, 30% more efficient than your old gas furnace. In fact, you can save up to $300 in rebates on a complete carrier heating and cooling system. That's just one example of the special savings that could be yours on carrier heating products from Custom Air. Custom Air, with carrier sales, service, and installation, 24-hour service, and custom design capabilities for your home or business. Custom Air serves the Delaware Valley. For your new carrier gas furnace and $150 rebate, call 638-0218. That's 638-0218. And it'll feel like winter tonight, won't it, Dick?
Absolutely. We'll have pretty good frost in the northern and western suburbs, and it'll be near freezing in the center city area. And that concludes today's forecast.
Just bring your pumpkins in.
Yes, bring in your pumpkins, your begonias, and anything else that may be affected by the frost. In fact, you may even want to drag your uncle off the driveway. Who can tell? All kinds of things like that.
I had a little pumpkin out on our back deck getting ready to be carved, and we found that some little beastie in the neighborhood's already started carving it for us.
Oh, you have raccoons.
Yes, we do.
Yes, they do love pumpkins. God bless their little bodies. We had a bunch of them out here. We had Halloween hikes here on Thursday and Friday night. And we left the pumpkins out overnight Thursday night, and we had a lot of very happy-looking raccoons on Friday.
Now, tell me something about pumpkins. Why are there so many of them? I mean, after all, people buy them, they cut open the top, they throw all the junk out, they cut eyes, nose, and mouth in it, and then when it turns rotten, they throw it away. If they want to make a pie, they buy it in a can.
It's all because of the great pumpkin who rises out of the pumpkin patch on Halloween. Never heard of that one, huh? No, actually, the reason is it's the most popular squash in North America and was a food staple at the time of the Pilgrims' arrival in New England, and the Indians liked it, and the Americans adapted it very neatly, and we have a lot of folks who raise them. There's not much chance of our running out of pumpkins in the next 5 or 6 years.
Oh, I was worried sick about that.
I thought you might be. I noticed a note of concern in your voice.
Back to the weather, my friend.
Bordering on hysteria, my... Well, for those of you who like hysterical weather, this is not going to be your kind of week. High-pressure system in the Ohio River Valley is going to hold just absolute total dominance over our weather for the next 3 days. And then as it slowly gives way to a warming trend coming out of the Midwest, we ain't going to have nothing but good weather for the next 5 days, so we might as well enjoy it. Today, it'll be mostly sunny. The winds will be sponsored as a result of a low-pressure system in Maine colliding with a high-pressure system in Ohio, and the two of them squeezing the air will simply produce winds that'll make it feel very chilly around here today. I think somebody mentioned windshield charts of courses of about 25 degrees, and if that's true, you should be dressed when you go outside, that's for sure. So mostly sunny, windy and cool, frost tonight, daytime high 53, overnight low in the suburbs in the upper 20s to low 30s. Tomorrow, sunny and milder as we get on the western side of that high-pressure system. Our daytime high on Tuesday, 62 degrees. By the time we get to Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, the warm air that's been stacking up in the upper Midwest is going to move our way and keep our temperatures moving steadily upward, 65 for a daytime high on Wednesday, 68 on Thursday, and up to 70 degrees by Friday. What does that mean for the weekend? We'll talk about that later. But for today, mostly sunny, windy and cool, frost tonight, daytime high 53. And now back to the great pumpkin of WFLN.
Thank you very much, Dick James, who for various reasons will be sure to be clothed when he goes outside. 12 and a half minutes before 9 o'clock, Dick James and Skywatch, brought to you this morning by Custom Air. Custom designing carrier heating and cooling systems for your home or business. Call 638-0218.
The following is a paid political announcement.
This is Sam Katz. I'm a Philadelphia businessman, and my company is the nation's leader in municipal finance. Today is the first of many opportunities in which I hope to voice my strategy for turning our city around. As you've probably heard, I have a strong desire to help bring about real change in Philadelphia. Philadelphians have had 40 years of continuous rule by the Democratic Party, and I think 40 years is far too long. We can end one-party rule of City Hall in next year's elections, but let's not wait until next year to get moving. That's why today I'd like to urge you to vote for the Republican candidates for the State House and the State Senate in the November 6th elections. By voting for the Republican team in Harrisburg, we'll send the politicians a message that Philadelphians are ready for a different kind of government. And take it from me, Sam Katz. Next year, we'll get real change in City Hall.
Paid for by Philadelphia 2000, a citizens committee to support Sam Katz for mayor.
WFLN time, 11 before 9.